tonight's Green Report, we head to New York, where early this month, New York Attorney General Eric Schneiderman served Exxon a subpoena. The subpoena is part of a state investigation whether Exxon misled the public about the risks of climate change. We know the answer to that, but the investigation's going on. Exxon has promoted climate change denial through their pals at ALEC. According to Lisa Graves, the executive director for the Center for Media and Democracy, ExxonMobil has bankrolled ALEC for decades and has a seat at ALEC's corporate board as ALEC has plied legislators with disinformation and denial about climate change and pushed legislation and resolutions to block crucial federal and state efforts to address the climate crisis. And if that's true, it's going to be serious strength for the case, especially after internal memos released earlier this year showed that Exxon knew about climate change all the way back to 1977. Here now to discuss Exxon's long history of bankrolling ALEC and its role in ALEC's corporate board is Brendan Fischer, General Counsel for the Center for Media and Democracy. Brendan, give us a quick refresher about the Exxon saga. What did they know and how did they cover it up?
Sure. Well, so as you said, back in 1977, Exxon's own scientists acknowledged that carbon emissions were causing climate change. And instead of disclosing that to shareholders and disclosing that to the public, they launched a long campaign to cover it up. And eventually, they actively funded groups like ALEC to spin the science around climate change and advance this notion that there's some sort of scientific uncertainty about the fact that carbon emissions cause climate change. We found a document from 1989 developed by Exxon laying out a plan to deceive the public about the fact that carbon emissions cause climate change and to create the notion that there's scientific uncertainty about the connection between carbon emissions and climate change. And ALEC was listed as one of the key players in this campaign that Exxon and other oil companies developed. And in the following years, Exxon would go on to give millions of dollars to ALEC. Between 2003 and 2005 alone, ExxonMobil earmarked $428,000 to ALEC for work on climate change. And throughout that entire period, ALEC promoted the notion that there was scientific uncertainty about climate change and that government should do nothing to limit carbon emissions, which would be great for Exxon's business model.
Okay. Brendan, we saw this same thing play. We see it all. It plays out constantly. They're called biostitutes. They hire these people to say, listen, we can't know. Science can't know. We don't have any way of really knowing whether cigarette smoke causes lung cancer. We don't have any way of knowing whether FinFin actually causes a heart attack. We need more studies. And what we find is ALEC, the same people who run ALEC, were some of the same people who came up with that defense. How is media reacting to this? Is media, corporate media anyway, how's corporate media looking through this and actually getting to the truth, if at all?
Well, there's been limited coverage of this. There's been a few articles about the fact that ExxonMobil deceived the public. Some great reports in the LA Times and the New York Times and Inside Climate News and other places. I think the ALEC connection has been less covered. We know that Attorney General Schneiderman is looking at ExxonMobil's funding of ALEC as part of his investigation, but ALEC continues to try and promote this idea that they don't deny climate change. And this is despite hosting speakers like the Heartland Institute telling state legislators that the science is unsettled and that carbon emissions may even be beneficial for the environment. You know, other corporations are recognizing that funding ALEC and funding ALEC's climate change denial is a risk. Google, Microsoft, Yelp, Yahoo, a number of different tech companies have all dropped their ALEC membership over the last year because ALEC actively promotes climate change denial. And these are companies that have a stated commitment to environmentalism. And I think corporate America, in many cases, is not buying ALEC's line, but corporate media, in many cases, are just repeating the talking points that ALEC is putting out there.
Oh, yeah. It's almost like corporate media has brain death. I don't know why people even turn on the news anymore to watch corporate media, because they don't even know the questions to ask. But I'll tell you this much. I mean, it seems very logical that if you're Schneiderman and you're looking at these facts, you do bring in ALEC, and you do bring in other organizations like ALEC that have furthered this lie. You're going to find documents, don't you think, Brendan, that directly between Exxon and ALEC talking about how they're going to promote this lie.
That's what we're hoping that he's going to look into. And we presented a significant amount of evidence in our letter to Attorney General Schneiderman, and we think he should look for those contracts, find out what Exxon was getting in exchange for its funding to ALEC. And ALEC is a pay-to-play operation. They don't do things of their own accord. They do things because a corporation like ExxonMobil is paying them. And that was made very clear.
Brendan Fischer, I got to go. Thank you for joining us. Please keep up the good work. Thanks for being here tonight.